Welcome, book enthusiasts. Today, we're embarking on an enlightening journey through the motivational masterpiece, How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. This timeless book consists of 30 insightful chapters that offer practical wisdom for personal and professional success. Before we delve into the chapters, let's take a moment to learn about the remarkable life of the author, Dale Carnegie. Dale Carnegie, born in 1888, was an influential American writer, lecturer, and self-improvement expert. He dedicated his life to understanding human nature and empowering individuals to build strong relationships and achieve their goals. Carnegie's experiences and observations served as the foundation for the invaluable principles shared in this book. Now, let's embark on an overview of the captivating chapters found within How to Win Friends and Influence People. Chapter 1: Techniques in Handling People. In this chapter, Dale Carnegie introduces fundamental techniques for handling people effectively. He emphasizes the importance of avoiding criticism and instead expressing appreciation. By developing a genuine interest in others and understanding their perspectives, we can build strong and positive relationships. Chapter 2: 6 Ways to Make People Like You. Carnegie explores practical strategies for fostering genuine connections and making people like us. By becoming good listeners, making others feel important, and finding common ground, we can create meaningful relationships based on trust and understanding. Chapter 3: How to Win People to Your Way of Thinking. In this chapter, Carnegie reveals the art of persuasion and influencing others positively. He emphasizes the importance of avoiding arguments, seeing from others' perspectives, and finding mutually beneficial solutions. By mastering these techniques, we can win people over to our way of thinking with grace and effectiveness. Chapter 4: Be a Leader: How to Change People Without Giving Offense or Arousing Resentment. Leadership skills are vital in all aspects of life. Carnegie delves into effective leadership principles that inspire and motivate others. He explores the power of praise, giving constructive feedback, and creating a positive work environment. By implementing these practices, we can become influential leaders who inspire lasting change. Chapter 5: The Secret of Socrates. Drawing inspiration from Socrates, Carnegie highlights the importance of asking questions to influence others positively. By guiding conversations and allowing individuals to express their thoughts, we can foster deeper connections and understanding. Chapter 6: Getting Others to See Your Point of View. Carnegie provides practical strategies for getting others to see our point of view without arousing resistance. By approaching discussions with humility, actively listening, and appealing to others' interests, we can effectively communicate our ideas and gain support. Chapter 7: A Formula That Will Work Wonders for You. In this chapter, Carnegie introduces a formula for handling people and achieving successful outcomes in various situations. By combining empathy, genuine interest, and positive communication, we can navigate challenging interactions and build fruitful relationships. Chapter 8: What Everybody Wants. Carnegie explores the innate human desire for recognition and importance. By understanding this fundamental need, we can connect with others on a deeper level and foster meaningful relationships built on respect and appreciation. Chapter 9: An Appeal That Everybody Likes. In this chapter, Carnegie discusses the power of sincere praise and appreciation. He explains how genuine compliments can motivate and inspire others, leading to improved relationships and increased cooperation. Chapter 10. The movies do it, TV does it. Why don't you do it? Drawing inspiration from the entertainment industry, Carnegie emphasizes the importance of creating engaging and compelling experiences for others. By incorporating storytelling and captivating communication techniques, we can effectively convey our messages and leave a lasting impact. Chapter 11. When nothing else works, try this. Carnegie introduces a powerful technique for resolving conflicts and diffusing tense situations. He advocates for admitting mistakes and taking responsibility, which can lead to reconciliation and open the door for positive change. Chapter 12. The High Road to a Man's Reason. In this chapter, Carnegie explores the concept of influencing others through reason and logic. He highlights the importance of presenting ideas in a clear and rational manner to gain support and cooperation. Chapter 13. Do this and you'll be welcome anywhere. Carnegie emphasizes the significance of practicing empathy and understanding. By putting ourselves in others' shoes, we can relate to their experiences, build trust, and create an environment where we are welcomed and respected. Chapter 14. A Simple Way to Make a Good First Impression. First impressions matter, and Carnegie provides valuable insights on making a positive impact from the start. By showing genuine interest, maintaining a positive demeanor, and being attentive, we can create a favorable impression and build strong connections. Chapter 15. If you don't do this, you are headed for trouble. Carnegie discusses the importance of avoiding arguments and criticism. Instead, he encourages listeners to focus on finding common ground, understanding others' perspectives, and seeking mutually beneficial solutions to prevent unnecessary conflicts. Chapter 16. An Easy Way to Become a Good Conversationalist. In this chapter, Carnegie shares practical tips for becoming a skilled conversationalist. By being genuinely interested in others, actively listening, and asking open-ended questions, we can engage in meaningful conversations and forge deeper connections. Chapter 17. How to Get Cooperation. Carnegie delves into strategies for gaining cooperation from others. By appealing to their interests, highlighting the benefits, and involving them in the decision-making process, we can foster a sense of ownership and collaboration. Chapter 18. A Formula for Winning People to Your Way of Thinking. Building on previous chapters, Carnegie presents a formula for effectively influencing others' opinions and gaining their support. The formula combines empathy, understanding, and persuasive communication techniques to create win-win situations. Chapter 19. What Everybody Wants. Carnegie revisits the fundamental human desire for recognition and importance. He demonstrates how acknowledging others' achievements and making them feel valued can lead to stronger relationships and increased cooperation. Chapter 20. How to Win People Without Offending Them. In this chapter, Carnegie provides guidance on avoiding behaviors that may offend or alienate others. He emphasizes the importance of showing respect, refraining from criticism, and practicing diplomacy to maintain positive relationships. Chapter 21. Creating a Positive Work Environment. Carnegie focuses on the significance of fostering a positive work environment. By providing sincere appreciation, recognizing others' efforts, and promoting a supportive culture, we can enhance productivity, motivation, and overall job satisfaction. Chapter 22, Making People Glad to Do What You Want. Carnegie explores strategies for influencing others to willingly support our ideas and goals. By understanding their motivations, aligning their interests with ours, and offering incentives, we can inspire enthusiasm and cooperation. Chapter 23, The Way to Make People Like You Instantly. In this chapter, Carnegie shares techniques for making an instant positive impression on others. He highlights the importance of smiling, showing genuine interest, and remembering and using people's names, which can create a sense of warmth and connection. Chapter 24, How to Win People to Your Thinking. Carnegie expands on previous chapters' ideas and provides additional strategies for winning people over to our way of thinking. By presenting ideas confidently, appealing to their interests, and providing logical reasoning, we can effectively influence others' perspectives. Chapter 25, The Secret of Socrates. In this chapter, Carnegie revisits the concept of Socratic questioning and its power to influence others. He delves into techniques for effectively communicating our ideas and getting others to see our point of view. By approaching discussions with humility, actively listening, and appealing to their interests, we can bridge gaps, foster understanding, and gain support. Chapter 26, Getting Others to See Your Point of View. Carnegie provides practical techniques for effectively communicating our ideas and getting others to see our point of view. By approaching discussions with humility, actively listening, and appealing to their interests, we can bridge gaps and foster understanding. Chapter 27, Creating a Positive Atmosphere. In this chapter, Dale Carnegie emphasizes the significance of creating a positive atmosphere in our interactions and environments. He highlights that a positive atmosphere fosters engagement, cooperation, and overall well-being. Carnegie explores practical strategies for cultivating positivity, such as expressing sincere appreciation, providing constructive feedback, and cultivating a supportive culture. By consciously creating a positive atmosphere, we can enhance relationships, boost morale, and create an environment where individuals thrive and work together harmoniously. Chapter 28, The Dramatic Episode. Carnegie discusses the impact of storytelling and dramatic elements in capturing people's attention and conveying messages effectively. He explores techniques for incorporating storytelling into conversations and presentations to make them more engaging and memorable. Chapter 29, When Nothing Else Works, Try This. Carnegie shares a powerful technique for handling difficult situations and resolving conflicts. He suggests approaching conflicts with a calm and understanding demeanor, listening attentively, and finding common ground to reach a mutually beneficial resolution. Chapter 30, Making a Lasting Impact. In the final chapter, Carnegie emphasizes the importance of making a lasting impact on others. By creating an environment of appreciation and respect, being genuine in our interactions, and consistently demonstrating kindness and empathy, we can leave a positive and memorable impression on those we encounter. This chapter focuses on the long-term effects of building strong relationships and fostering a positive influence in our interactions with others. How to win friends and influence people is a treasure trove of wisdom. Throughout the book, Carnegie emphasizes the power of empathy, understanding, and genuine human connection. By applying these principles, readers can strengthen their relationships, enhance their influence, and achieve personal and professional success. In summary, How to Win Friends and Influence People is a transformative guide that unlocks the secrets to effective communication, leadership, and building meaningful connections. Dale Carnegie's timeless principles continue to inspire and empower individuals around the world. Let's embrace these valuable lessons and embark on a journey of personal growth and influence. Thank you for joining me on this enlightening exploration of How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. Remember, the true power of this book lies in its application in our daily lives. Let's strive to embody the principles shared within and create a positive impact on those around us. Until next time, you can find more inspiring books review in the playlist section. Keep reading, keep learning, and keep growing. I hope this video inspired you to take action toward your goals. If you enjoyed, found this video helpful, and want more motivation and inspiration, make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. Thanks for watching.